It's really been great to drive around the state of South Dakota and hook up with everybody. And it's, I can't believe it's probably been, I don't know, 20 years.
20-some before I moved to Rapid City here, yes.
I very much love Middle Eastern food because I think it has one of the greatest cuisines.
I agree with you. I'm very biased.
No, but it's just amazing. And now you just have brought out two of the dishes that you make. And what is this?
This is what we call fatayer.
And then how do you say it actually?
So it's like flat tire.
Like flat tire. So fatayer.
Okay. Yep.
Fatayer.
Uh-huh. And you have two different examples.
So this one is beef with pomegranate molasses and other spices. And this one, it's sweet potato with almond, sun-dried tomato, hot sauce, tahini sauce. So it has almost all the flavors in one pocket.
And then I noticed there's like two different shapes.
And we're increasing the numbers, but we do them, and each one is different design. This way my staff and the customers, they know if we make a mistake, oh no, no, they said, no, you gave me the wrong one. So each flavor, it has its own design.
Well, I would love to maybe sample one.
Oh, absolutely.
So you could like cut.
Yes.
Well, I'm curious, so and this one has ground beef and pomegranate molasses.
Yes.
Mm, it's really nice.
Thank you.
And I like that it's open face.
Uh-huh.
I certainly love meat, but I mean, every place you look, everybody serves meat, and it's really nice option to have more vegetables. And then you still do.
We still do chicken, we still do beef, but this is, you know, even the beef eaters, they are curious, you know, because it's not any more steamed broccoli. They are curious to taste the food. So we sell actually more vegan, vegetarian, even for the meat eater, because they can have the meat everywhere else. And they're so curious, you know, how to make sweet potato taste savory.
I look at Syria and I think of like Eastern Mediterranean.
Eastern Mediterranean. You actually, Syria, Lebanon, what you have now, Israel, all this is what's called the Eastern Mediterranean, Turkey,
yeah.
Greece, and everybody claimed to be the healthiest. But according to all the research, the East Mediterranean one is the healthiest one. The reason, just by accident, by geography, the land are so small, so they can't have cattle, herds. Each family will have one cow. From that cow, they make the cheese, they make the yogurt. So the meat is a rare event because it's so expensive. So they eat mostly grains, bulgur wheat, they eat mostly beans, olives, bread. So just by accident, it came to be the healthiest one.
Well, I'm sure it's a really great way to connect with the people of South Dakota and maybe have them connect to, you know, Syria and...
Yeah, when we opened, you know, a lot of people said, like, you're out of your mind, this is South Dakota. Black pepper for them is too spicy. You know, you have to have to survive, you have to have a burger and French fries. And I said, you know, if you just stand there's like 5 burger and French fries around me. Why would I open, you know, and I'm from the Middle East, you know, I need them to try something different.
Now, how about sourcing? Is that a problem? I mean, trying to find certain ingredients that maybe...
Not anymore, you know, I mean, now with the, thank God, we, you know, so we get some vegetables, like in summertime, some couple farmers. But most the ethnic ingredient, we get them from Chicago. But because my father was a farmer, I had the most respect and sympathy for all farmers, because it's one of the toughest jobs. You see, our job as a chef is tough, but we're still indoor. We're not under the mercy of weather.
Oh, yeah. So it seems like with all this wonderful food, how do you think it's helped to form a community?
But you know, they by coming to the restaurant and being exposed to the food, they realize that there's a whole culture. Even when they see me, they talk to me, they know, okay, I'm Syrian, so that's how the Syrian look like. Because sometimes you see the footage on TV and, you know, even Syria is the most, Damascus is the oldest capital in the whole world. By talking to me and other Syrian community, they understand now, you know, about our culture, and they welcome us more, and they're more tolerant.
Well, they put a face with them.
Yeah, exactly.
Now this is exciting. So this is some different dessert options.
Yep, some of the desserts we have. This is, we call it fennel tea cookie.
Fennel tea cookie.
It has a fennel seed in it.
So are they ground?
Ground, yes.
Okay, ground.
So it's not very strong.
Okay.
Just subtle flavor.
Well, I'm going to taste something. I'm going to taste.
This one you have to break it with your hand because usually
Well, there's a shape on it. Is it from a mold?
Yes.
Or something?
Yeah. Actually, the mold. It's my grandmother's mold because when they used to ship me the cookies, and then I said just ship me the mold and the recipe and I'll make it. I'm a chef, you know. So they did, and now I make it here and became very popular in the restaurant.
That's wonderful. So is there a way to say like bon appetit in Arabic?
Yes, we in Syria and Lebanon we say sahtain. Saha means health. Sahtain does mean to health. So whenever we eat or drink, say sahtain.
Oh, okay.
So sahtain.
So sahtain.
Sahtain, yep.
Sahtain.
Yep.
How about delicious in Arabic?
Tayyib.
Kayyab.
Yep.
Sahtain.
Tayyib. Shukran, that means thank you. Shukran.